Yeah, hello from my side. My name is Puria Bigband. I'm with Aquatex since 2012. Before that, my background is process engineering. I was involved in the plant design and plant engineering of different offshore and onshore plants. So I'm coming from the process engineering and plant design industry background, and I started as a product design application consultant, and it's about 2 years that I'm working in the product management, and since last year as a director of product management. So this is the vision that we had more than 10 years ago. The vision was that there should be a platform that contains the complete plant engineering data model, and all the disciplines which are involved should work in parallel together. There should not be any boundary between them. There should not be any import or export, and they have to work in parallel to each other. There is no arrow, there is no start or end. This was the vision from the beginning. And we called it Cooperation Plant Engineering Platform. This is the status that we have today. More than 11,000 active engineering-based licenses are active in the customer side, and they are used mostly in the basic process engineering part, in the instrumentation and process automation, detail engineering, and electrical engineering. So this is the current status, and this is proven by all our customers that this is the technology of next decade. This is the technology of next 10 to 20 years, and it is valid for modern plant engineering. We took 12 steps forward in the last 2 years to go further, to go towards the modern plant engineering. And I will explain these 12 steps forward. So the first step is that we created more than 40 new features targeting conceptual designers and process engineers. I will not explain them in detail, this is not interesting for you, but we are creating all the state-of-the-art features and functionalities that conceptual designers in the field and process engineers in the process engineering design need to design the plant. So they will have all the tools that they need to complete the plant engineering data model in their own disciplines. This is what we are going to release in EB 2018, and by this, we are covering the complete disciplines that are involved in the core engineering of the plant engineering. So this would be the first structured unified plant data model for complete core engineering of plant design or plant engineering. Probably you heard this plant digital twin term a lot during the exhibition, and what we understand from plant digital twin is a little bit different from other involved companies in the topic. We think that plant digital twin, what is discussed at the moment by a lot of companies, is actually plant digital body. So you have a plant, it's a real physical plant, and then you want to have a digital model of that plant. You cannot call it digital twin because this is just a body of that plant. You have it in 2D, you have it in 3D. These are all the body of that plant. That plant, if it should be a digital twin, it should have a digital soul. And this is what we are focusing on in the next release of Engineering Base. So if you combine the body and soul together, then you will end up with a plant digital twin. Before that, you don't have it. You just have a 2D representations, maybe 1D representations, and maybe 3D representations. So it's just a body. And the plant digital soul is one of the focuses that we are going to have. So for that, we created the scenarios and cases, and of course, operation modes inside the plant. We called it shadows of plant data model. So we went one step after the plant data model. We said, you have the complete plant data model, but now you need the shadows of that for different operation modes, for a startup, shutdown, and for different scenarios, for high quality, low energy consumption, for different scenarios that you can design in your plant engineering. Therefore, we have the complete management of scenarios and operation modes in the complete plant engineering. You have to remember that this is valid for the complete plant engineering. It means conceptual design, process design, instrumentation, electrical, maintenance, and so on. This was step two. Step three, we created a cause and effect management, which is valid again for the complete plant engineering. We have some cause and effect in the market at the moment, but it's focused on automation. What we did is we created this cause and effect topic for the complete plant engineering. This means that it has multi-levels. This means that in the process engineering, you can say, if I open a valve, this is the effect. In the automation, you can say signal A to signal B. So it has multiple levels, but integrated in one platform, in one data model. Step four is rule-based plant engineering. At the moment, we have rule-based in P&ID, rule-based in different disciplines. We combine everything together in one database, in one data model, and then you have the complete plant engineering rule-based. This means that these rules can be discipline independent, can be a rule between the process engineers and logic diagrams. So there can be a complete integration or communication between the rules between different disciplines. This is a step four. Step five is automatic tracking of the history for the plant digital model. This means that at any point of time, as an owner operator, as an EPC, you can go back to the data model and ask the data model, what was my status in last April? What was the status of my plant in last June? So as is something normal, as built, and we created as was status. So the engineers or the managers can see what was the as was the status of my plant during some time. And of course, everybody can track on each object all the details of the object and history of the object. So this was a step five. Step six is that for the plant engineering, this is not possible for the engineers to search everything like a traditional search. We added above engineering-based artificial intelligence and the Google-like search that easily with the normal speaking language, you can search and then the system will show you the most relevant and related results, exactly like Google. So you go to a website, this is the website, this is a screenshot of the website, and then you can search in your normal language and then it will show you all the relevant results from the search. The most important part here is that, and that's the involvement of artificial intelligence, is that we can search solutions. So it's not that I want to search for a valve. I want to search for a solution, for example, a distillation column that gives me the separation of 95%. And this is the solution. This is not an object that I want to find it. This is a combined different scenarios and different objects and associations together. And artificial intelligence will find that solution for you and will give you how much is relevant to your request. And for the next time, when you search something and accept it or take it, it will learn that what is your direction of search. So that's the machine learning part. And we think that this is absolutely necessary if you want to increase the speed of design, especially in the conceptual design, especially in the concept phase that you are looking for the solutions. You're not looking for a template or a typical. This is very important for us to know and to have it in the engineering base. This was a step six, and step seven basically is a DCS portal. We said that when you have the plant engineering, plant data model completely in one database, it should not make a difference that if you are an EPC, today you want to work with ABB, tomorrow you want to work with Siemens. So you should be able to send this data to different DCS tools. And therefore, we created a DCS portal that you can easily configure and send the same data in the plant engineering or plant data model directly to different disciplines, to different DCS tools with different configurations. So this was step seven. Step eight, we created a project execution management. We created a functionality that owner operators and EPCs can seamlessly communicate together based on the data, based on the documents. So for example, here you have the as-built project, you have a parallel project A, and then when you have a parallel project C, there is a data coming from as-built and also data coming from project A. So all of the EPCs even together can communicate the data and can see the current status of the project. And this is, again, in the direction of as-built, as-is, and as-was. So execution management for seamless multi-level data communication between owner-operators and EPCs. Next one is the standard plant maintenance app. We are releasing a maintenance app, which is covering all the normal activities of a maintenance person that can go to the plant, can scan the QR code, can see the tasks from the engineering base that are the maintenance tasks, normal or abruptions or sudden tasks, and he can access to the complete plant data model in his tablet without any need of going to the computer or printing something. So this is a maintenance app that we are creating, and it's going to be released with EBE 2018. Step 10 is virtual reality and 3D. We already have a lot of 3D integrations, standard 3D integrations. we expanded that to new tools, to new 3D tools, and of course, we added the virtual reality. We are going to show in Achema that you can navigate in the plant with virtual reality, and then you can click on any device, and then you can see the complete documentation of that device from different disciplines, from P&ID, from electrical instrumentation, and so on. And even you can navigate from the 2D to a new device, and then you will be landed on the virtual reality in a different device. So in principle, you can navigate between virtual reality and 2D documentation easily with some navigation on the 2D or on the 3D, and then you can see all the as-built data in the virtual reality. Step 11 is a cooperation that we are doing with a partner, ePro, and we started a campaign. We started a campaign to migrate the legacy data of the owner operators into a structured plant data model. And so far, we have a very good reference together with Olin. We made the project. It's a very big project, and we migrated a lot of P&IDs and other diagrams into engineering base. And this is going to be continued with another owner operators and future owner operators that will use engineering base. But basically, the campaign is focused on migrating the legacy data from whatever system that they have today into engineering base and structure it in a plant data model. And the last step that we took is to create the products that are fitting exactly to the disciplines of plant engineering. So there would not be any options or variants that you have to select when you want to use it. There are clear products directly targeting to the disciplines, and then the customers or current customers or new customers will or can buy these products which fit exactly to the disciplines, and they don't need any extra options or variants. When they buy a product, it has everything that they need for that discipline. And this is a new product portfolio that we are going to release in 2018. Thank you, Ruben.